So here now we will discuss how to localize tumor in Zollinger-Ilson syndrome. So what imaging should be done? So first of all, upper endoscopy, if not already performed, cross-sectional imaging with helical contrast enhanced triple phase CT or MRI and somatin receptor based imaging like somatin receptor scintigraphy using 111 pentriotide or integrated PET CT using gallium dota octreotide. Okay, because of its greater sensitivity, gallium 68 dotate or gallium dotatoc PET imaging may be preferable to conventional somatostatin receptor scintigraphy with 111 pentriotide. And if CT MRI and somatostatin receptor based imaging are negative and surgery is being considered, endoscopic ultrasound should be performed because of its greater sensitivity in detecting small tumors. And endoscopic ultrasound permits fine needle aspiration for histologic identification. We reserve imaging testing to localize the tumor with angiography or selective arterial stimulation and venous sampling with secretin injection for patients who are strongly suspected of having gastrinoma in whom imaging is negative. However, in some cases, tumor localization can only be achieved at laparotomy by direct palpation, duodenal transillumination or intraoperative ultrasound. Okay, and we suggest biochemical studies to screen for multiple endocrine neoplasia 1 in patients with Zollinger-Ilson syndrome, as 20-25% of patients have multiple endocrine neoplasia 1, and because up to 40% of multiple endocrine neoplasia 1 or Zollinger-Ilson syndrome have no family history. All patients with Zollinger-Ilson syndrome should have serum PTS, ionized calcium and prolactin levels at diagnosis and periodically thereafter. Okay. So all patients with gastrinoma should at least be considered for testing for inherited genetic syndrome. Okay. So now let's summarize. So Zollinger-Ilson syndrome is caused by secretion of gastrin by duodenal or pancreatic neuroendocrine tumor, gastrinoma. So most patients are diagnosed between age 20-50 with higher incidence in men as compared to women. So while most gastrinoma are sporadic, about 20-30% occur in association with main one syndrome, okay, and approximately 50-88% of sporadic Zollinger-Ilson syndrome patients and 70-100% of Zollinger-Ilson syndrome and main one have duodenal gastrinoma. Okay, so approximately 50-88% of sporadic Zollinger-Ilson syndrome patients and 70-100% of Zollinger-Ilson syndrome and main one have duodenal gastrinoma. Excessive gastrin secretion from gastrinoma results in high gastric acid output. Chronic diarrhea results from failure of resorption of increased gastric acid, inactivation of pancreatic enzymes, damage to the intestinal epithelium and inhibition of the absorption of sodium and water. Okay. So 90%, above 90% of patients with Zollinger-Ilson syndrome have peptic ulcers. And patients with Zollinger-Ilson syndrome often present with solitary ulcer less than 1 cm in diameter. Approximately 75% of the ulcer are in the first part of duodenum. Okay. On upper endoscopy, patients with Zollinger Ehlers-Danlos syndrome may have prominent gastric folds and evidence of reflux esophagitis. Zollinger Ehlers-Danlos syndrome should be suspected in patients with multiple or refractory peptic ulcers or venous ulcer distal to duodenum, peptic ulcers, disease and diarrhea, enlarged gastric folds, and endocrinopathy or multiple endocrinoplasia type 1. Okay. And tumor localization begins with upper endoscopy if not already performed. Upper endoscopy. Okay. Cross-sectional imaging with helical contrast enhanced triple phase CT or MRI. And somatin statin receptor based imaging using somatostatin receptor scintigraphy with 111 ion pentriotide or integrated PET CT using gallium dotate. Because of its greater sensitivity, gallium dotate or gallium dotato PET CT is preferred over conventional somatostatin receptor scintigraphy with 111 pentotide where available. If CT MRI or MRI and somatostatin receptor imaging are negative and surgery is being considered, endoscopic ultrasound should be performed to localize the tumor. We reserve invasive testing to localize the tumor with angiography or selective arterial stimulation and venous sampling with secretin injection for patients who are strongly suspected of having gastrinoma in whom imaging is negative. However, in some cases, tumor localization can only be achieved at laparotomy by direct palpation, direct duodenal transillumination, or intraoperative ultrasound. And all patients with gastrinoma should at least be considered for testing for inherited genetic syndromes. 20-30% of patients develop Zollinger Ehlers-Danlos syndrome in the setting of ME1 syndrome, MEN1 syndrome. All patients with Zollinger Ehlers-Danlos syndrome should be screened for MEN1 syndrome with PTH, ionized calcium, prolactin at diagnosis and periodically thereafter. Okay.